Cool. So let's talk about what's kind of left out from this line. And I think it kind of leads into some questions that we get. And the first one is, of course, it's closed with, it says no sugar. And sugar is a source of carbohydrate, of course, and it's a source of glucose and fructose. And typically, wherever we see diseases of modern civilization, obesity, heart disease, cancer, we also see consumption of sugar. And so that's why that we want it to be generally eliminated from your diet, at least not one of those staple foods. Table sugar has about equal amounts of glucose and fructose. Honey has a little bit higher fructose. Agave nectar, which you know people will tell you it's paleo, so it's perfect, it's virtually all fructose. Our bodies, again, don't handle fructose very well, and that's probably one of the factors that's really driving us towards insulin resistance, and so that's one of the reasons that we're going to leave that out. Something else that's left out up there is some of our industrial seed oils or our vegetable oils. And these would be things like soybean oil, canola oil, safflower oil, any of those industrial, highly processed oils. And the reason is because they are high in polyunsaturated fats, and specifically the ones we don't want, specifically the omega-6 polyunsaturated fats. And even if you're eating clean, it can be hard to stay away from them completely, especially if you travel, especially if you eat out a lot.